Pivot tables present dimensions and measures as rows and columns in a table. In a pivot table, you can analyze data by multiple measures and in multiple dimensions at the same time. You can rearrange the measures and dimensions to get different views of the data. Moving measures and dimensions interchangeably between rows and columns is called pivoting. Pivot tables are particularly useful when you want to include several dimensions or measures in a single table and then want to reorganize them to see different subtotals. Another advantage is that you can expand the rows you are interested in while keeping the rest of the table collapsed. To create a pivot table, drag and drop a table chart onto your sheet. Add the first dimension, for example, customer. Then add a measure, for example, quantity. Feel free to add more dimensions and measures to your visualization. When you want to rearrange your data to get a new view, drag the items to a new row or column. For example, you can drag the customer dimension after the product group dimension. As a result, the dimensions are now sorted by item, primarily so the focus has shifted from customer to item. By expanding the dimensions, you can find out the quantities and sales for each customer, but there is another way to achieve that goal. By moving the dimension customer from rows to columns, you retain focus on the dimension item, but you also get the distribution of items per customer. The move has made the pivot table more information dense. As you may have noticed, quantity and sales are not presented as separate measures. Next to the dimension customer, you will find an item called values. You cannot split a measure item and use one measure as a row and another as a column, nor can you change the order in which the measures are presented. You can use global grouping in a pivot table. With global grouping, you use a limited data set, and in that data set, you single out values that you want to focus on. For example, the best quarters, the top salespersons, or the worst selling products. In this example, the values are sorted on sales. The list is long. Now we are going to apply a limitation to the sales rep name so that only the top 5 sales representatives are shown. You can now see the top 5 sales representatives for each year. The next step is to select global grouping in the properties panel. The global grouping option is only available when you have applied a limitation on the dimension. When global grouping is selected, the limitation of the top 5 sales representatives is applied again, but this time regardless of the dimension year. The 5 sales representatives with the highest sales are the only ones that will be presented in the final pivot table. Because 5 other sales representatives have higher sales than Brenda Gibson, she is knocked out of the list. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.